the defaults here. So the idea is that it's going to go into this folder where I have a bunch where the Angular generator is. And it essentially just more or less, you know, takes sort of the inputs that I said, you know, if I wanted to use Twitter Bootstrap, it sort of scaffolds out a project for me that's very opinionated in terms of, you know, where files should be, and it just makes a new project for me. So if you look at that once empty folder, I actually have, you know, the starts of my web application already up and going. Most of your code would go into the app directory. Yeoman comes with Node built in, so I'm just going to run a local server so you can see what this default application looks like. So essentially, it's got like a hero box and it's got some text in here. So if I'm just going to open up the index file here, you can see that it's a little bit more complex, where the Angular app actually has a namespace now. So this is a much better way of organizing your code. And because this is a multi-view web application, it uses something called ng-view to say, you know, I'm going to use multiple views, and whenever you go to a new page, just dynamically load in the view that I'm looking for. All your views end up in this views folder. So I'm actually going to just very quickly add in here a little message that I'm going to use a bit later. And another cool Angular tag is, you never have to like go into write a for loop ever again, because you just use ng repeat and it's going to loop through an array. So if I kind of look at into my scripts folder and I look at my controllers, there's a pair for main.html, which is main.js. All this sort of boilerplate code is already scaffolded out for me, so I actually don't need to do very much at all. So I'm just going to update a little message here. So when you look at the application now, like, it was very quick for me to just get up and started to make an Angular application. But it does also does some very cool things too, where, you know, you're not going to have a one-page web application. In most cases, you'll probably have multiple views. So you can actually use Angular. And so I'm in the same directory. I can go yeoman init Angular. And I can say that I want to make a route, which means I want to make a view and a controller at the same time. I'm just going to call it jQuery test. And so it actually just goes ahead and actually makes both my view and my controller for me. So I don't know if you can actually see this, but in my controllers, I just got a new file, jQuery test. In my views, I also got a jQuery test.html. And then kind of the awesome thing is in my index file, it's already wired up in there, so I actually don't need to do very much work at all. So using Yeoman with Angular, it's like a really awesome way to really get your application done really quickly. And I think I'm running out of time, but another cool thing with Angular, especially if you're more advanced, is that when you're using it with Yeoman also, it's scaffolds out a test, unit test for you. So, you know, if you're more advanced, like, you can stop that lazy excuse that, you know, starting a file is going to stop you from doing unit tests, because this Yeoman scaffold already does it for you. Directives, go to Alex Tucker's talk at noon today. He's going to go do a deep dive into directives, but it's great because Angular just encapsulates all your data for you into this one file. So it keeps your HTML very clean, and it sort of feels like a web component, like sort of the way web browsers are sort of moving towards, you know, encapsulating all this data so you don't have divs within divs that don't make any semantic sense. Like, you can use a directive. So when you look at a tag in your web page, it makes sense that when you look at it and you see that it's a date picker, you don't have to worry about looking at all these nested divs just to figure out what's going on. You just know it's going to be a date picker. You can worry about what's actually inside of it later. Filters is what I use to do sort of filtering on my browse list. So there's also an Angular generator for that. And perfect timing. So if you want to learn a bit more about Angular, definitely check out the, you know, the official Angular website. If you're on Google Plus, I find that the Angular Google Plus community is pretty awesome for beginners and advanced people, because the Angular team checks it out all the time, so they're really open to answering questions. And then also other Angular people, developers are very passionate, so typically you get a reply to almost all of your posts. And if you're just looking, there's egghead.io, which is a very extensive video tutorial. So I haven't watched many of them, but it's quite extensive, so probably anything Angular, it's got it covered. So thank you so much for coming today. Sorry I had to rush through that, it's half an hour, but definitely go check out Alex Tucker's talk, because it'll be more of a deep dive. But you can sort of see that I just made an Angular application in this last 5 minutes of this talk, so it's definitely very easy to get started. And I'll do some plugs where, if you're interested, if you're a JavaScript game developer and you're interested in adding like peripherals to your, like new sorts of peripherals to your JavaScript game, I have a Makey workshop next weekend, and I also have an Arduino breadboarding workshop next weekend too. And if you're looking for work, come talk to me. So thanks so much.